John Tysmark at 45.
The flag of what nation features a red maple leaf?
What? Toronto.
No.
Cry baby chicken, cry baby chicken, cry baby, cry baby.
Thanks, cowboy.
Sorry, Mr. Houston. You know, you shouldn't be lying down, and, you know, it's probably bad for your back.
Everything's in place. As soon as the reception starts, we make our move.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I now present Mr. and Mrs. Curtis Alden.
I'm afraid the Aldens are not receiving today. There's a wedding in
progress. Yes, Curtis. I know that. Huh? I'm here to see the groom, Mr. Curtis Alden.
Yes, madam, but excuse me.
Excuse me if I don't get up.
Are you... J.J., Billy! Stop! Stop!
Just because you wouldn't get a silly caterpillar. You said you'd go first.
Billy, you are going to go upstairs and get cleaned up. J.J., I'm calling your mother at the wedding, too.
Baby!
It's up, guy. Come here. You're pretty handy with those fists, aren't you? When I was your age, I used to beat up all the kids in the neighborhood.
Billy's a sissy.
Yeah. Well, when my dad left, I got real mad. I used to take it out on my little brother. But when I got older, I realized I should have been protecting him instead of hitting him.
What exactly does this have to do with me? Billy, he isn't my brother.
No, but a strong kid like you needs to protect weaker kids instead of hurting them.
Why?
Didn't your mom ever tell you about King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table?
Who?
Arthur was a young kid like you. And one day, he pulled a sword out of the stone and became King of England.
Silly stories for silly babies.
Well, they were hardly babies. King Arthur had all these knights who used to go around fighting and bashing people, show how strong they were, and that might was right. But then Lancelot joined the round table, and he figured out it was better to use right for might.
Boring.
Oh, yeah? Well, help me get up on the couch and listen up, young man, because you're going to learn something whether you like it or not.
No, but, Kate, one simply doesn't just run off and ignore the receiving line.
Isabelle, times have changed.
Not in my house, they haven't. Traditions are going to be upheld here until they lower me into the ground.
Well, maybe before they lower you, you should accept that tradition is not nearly as important
Is two people truly loving one another?
Kate, you seem to be changing right along with the times.
Well, one of us has got to.
Oh, Kate, honestly, you're impossible.
Mrs. Alden?
Say it again.
Mrs. Curtis Alden?
Tess, what the hell are you doing here?
Could you please get me another?
Thank you.
Oh, just the person I was looking for.
Jeremy, don't you have any other friends in Corinth to play with?
No one's to drop doorknobs on my lap.
Unless this is the handle of your heart or your bedroom.
Dream on.
Is there a note attached? Jeremy, I can't stand it any longer. Meet me in Corinth Towers in your...
I know exactly what you're up to.
Pretty cool wedding, isn't it?
Yeah, in spite of all the cool rain.
You know, Donnelly and Curtis are so happy. It kind of makes me think that everything's going to turn around for all of us.
Yeah.
Oh, Cooper. Cooper, dear, where are they?
Who?
Did you not just witness Dinah Lee and Curtis leaving?
Oh, yeah, that was excellent.
Excellent, it certainly was not. It was most improper to just desert the receiving line and leave all those nice people standing there.
That's right. Well, now they're all having a great time and partying and running around having fun.
Cooper, that is not the case, and how can you say such a thing?
Yes, protocol is protocol, isn't it? Yes.
Yes.
I think I have just the way to get them back.
If I could oh, Allison, make him turn it off. Oh, that's horrible. All the problems of
my world. Mrs. Alden?
Yes, Mr. Alden.
I think I hear them playing our song. Would you do me the honor of accompanying me to the dance floor?
Just another line to sign to steal my heart away. Yeah. Just let me hold you now. I want to feel you in my arms. Let me hold it now. Endlessly. Just let me hold you now.
Friendly. You know, I have a practical problem here. I'm supposed to dance with my mom.
Oh, so dance with her. Bring her back.
You'll be okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
I feel your touch, and it stirs me deep inside.
Don't step on her toes.
Ava, you stand still.
You know, contrary to your personal agenda, I happen to be here because this is the wedding of my best friend.
I know.
Well, then you stop pestering me. Are you naturally this relentless?
Just want to ask you to dance. You know how to dance, don't you?
Well, yes,
may I?
Dance. Yes, I suppose.
Thank you.
Nice to bump into you again. You wouldn't be happy to be sending your Alden limousine to pick up your lodger, are you?
Seems to me he's your lodger.
Guess
Mrs.
he is.
Forbes?
Yeah.
Excuse me, there's a telephone call for you. You're a sitter, I believe.
Oh, now look at that, Stacey. He misses you already.
Of course he does.
Excuse me.
Lennox, would you mind filling that for me?
Oh, of course, Mrs. Russell.
Thank you so much.
Why are you bringing a gift to a guy you hardly know to a wedding you weren't invited to, Tess?
I'm sorry. Trucker, I'm sorry. I can't imagine how you feel. Anyway, I'm not staying. I'm just dropping this off. I won't be bothering you and your family anymore. Excuse me.
What the hell are you doing?
Brought your wedding present.
Well, give it to Lennox and then leave.
Well, this is a very special gift. I think you might want to keep it separate from the others.
Tess, I might not want to open it at all.
I think that this is something that you would definitely want to open now.
Bye. What the hell is this?
A gun?
Don't be cute.
That was the weapon that was used to kill my husband. It's your gun.
How did you get it?
You dropped it in the desert. Did you forget?
I didn't forget how you and Buck both blew off, left me with the murder rap alone.
I told you that I was scared.
Let's just cut to the chase, Tess. How did you get this gun?
A friend was there a few minutes before the police showed up. Look, this is the last thing I have to link you to my husband's death. Take it.
You have been threatening me since you got back in Corinth, Tess. Why would you stop now?
I'm getting rid of my excess baggage as well as yours.
Uh-huh. So where's the extra suitcase with the catch in it?
It doesn't exist. Kuwait is past history. Gone. Past. Forgotten.
Yeah, until you decide to dredge it up again.
I promised you I wouldn't do that.
Your promises are like desert sand, Tess. They blow in the wind.
You're just gonna have to trust me on this. Now, can we just get on with our lives?
Curtis? What's going on?
I didn't know you invited Tess Wilder to the wedding.
I didn't. She was just dropping off a gift.
Oh, well then, let me find her and thank her.
She left. She's gone.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Both of you. I wish you all the happiness in the world.
Thanks, Jeremy. Could you excuse me for a second? I see my mom. I've got to go talk to her.
Sure.
Thanks.
Oh, boy. Clayton, I'm absolutely shocked. I never thought I'd see you dateless at an occasion.
Yeah, well, I'm getting picky in my old age. How about you, Gwyn? Your cowboy ride off on his horse? Leave you stranded?
What would possess you to do something like that? Making Billy eat that caterpillar was...
pretty inventive.
It was cruel, Buck. Do you want to end up with no friends, or is it my imagination?
It was a joke.
Really? Well, Billy wasn't laughing, was he?
I called up and I apologized.
You called him? On the phone? And said you were sorry?
Just like Lance thought would have done, right, Mr. Houston?
That's right, pard.
All right, everyone. Ladies, it's time to throw the bouquet. Come on, gather around. Single ladies, gather around. That's it. Very good.
You're the prettiest single lady in the room. Something to mop up the tears.
much. Don't you realize that I have just been publicly humiliated? I need some air. I need to get away from you. When I asked for a glass of champagne.
Sorry. Cheer up. You know what they say, don't you? You haven't lost a son, you've gained a daughter.
Clay, have you seen Ava?
She was inside a little bit ago.
Well, I know. I can't find her now.
You seem to have run out of champagne, but never mind. The party is over for you.